Good afternoon, guys, and happy Monday to all of your sunshiny faces, guys. I got up early today. I was actually up at, I think like 8:30 maybe or something like that, 9, maybe 9:30. But I didn't end up getting out of bed actually for like probably at least a good another hour after that. I think I got up around 10 o'clock or 10:30-ish. I didn't get out of bed, like I said, really early. So that part stunk about the day was that it was actually, because of over the weekends, like yesterday I wasn't up super, super early, but I think I still got up at like 8:30 so we could go to Menards. Because I was helping my dad clean the fish tank. And then on Saturday I was up early too so we could go to the grocery stores and do all that. Like probably again 8:30, you know, so decently early. And then today I was like, normally on Mondays I wind up, you know, kind of sleeping in because I'm tired from getting up those 2 days too, because normally on Friday nights and Saturday nights I go to bed kind of late, and so I get up early though on Saturday and Sunday. So you know, I'm not normally, I don't get that much sleep over the weekends, and I don't stay up like ridiculously late, but probably later than I do during the weekdays. So again, I ended up not getting that much sleep. So like normally on Mondays I will wind up sleeping in a little bit. So I was actually kind of surprised at myself for getting up at the time I did. But then again, I didn't actually get out of bed and get a good start to my day until much later. Stunk for today, but my dad did go to Menards and ended up getting the lattice that we need. We're actually gonna have a 4-foot by 3-foot chunk left over of the lattice. And I was like, what else can we use that for? Like, I'm trying to figure out stuff now as to where we can use it and what we can use it for, which would be, like I said, you know, something fun to do. What can we do with it? What kind of projects can we do? So it actually, now that I'm thinking about it, we might be able to put some of it, maybe not. I don't know. We're gonna build, because for some of the vegetable gardens, obviously not this year because we're kind of done with vegetables. I mean, not done, but we can still do some winter, you know, plants and fall plants and stuff like that. But for the most part, a lot of this stuff is kind of done. We need to start, did it obviously much earlier. Almost September is not the time to be starting a lot of stuff, except for, again, like lettuce, spinach, kale, and leaf plants and stuff like that. Those ones all can be grown and do pretty well in the fall and winter. So other than that, there's really nothing we can plant. But possibly for next year, we need to build like some A-frame sort of, so that we can grow some more like vining plants and that type of thing, like squash and melons and stuff like that. And so we need to build some of those things. And one of the things we were gonna do was we were actually, I think, going to put lattice behind, my dad left, the apartment next to the house left made the posts for the raised beds higher there so that we can actually put the lattice against it. So I'm actually thinking if we are gonna have leftovers, we can just wind up using that. So that would end up working out. That we have an extra piece. But I was trying to figure out, I was like, where else can we use it? What can we use it for? So that might be the best thing that we can do. Anyways, though, so my dad got that, that is gonna be stained most likely tomorrow. And then he also got 4 hooks for, because I told you guys yesterday, we just ended up improvising with some random things to hang the bird feeders that were outside. And we needed to get actual hooks. So we already had the screw holes drilled, but like I said, we just ended up putting like a couple of different types of, like, my dad used some pipe, like the same stuff that we ended up using for the pipe that is on the deck that we have the curtains hanging on. I forget what they're called, like 2-hole straps or something like that, but this was just a 1-hole strap, so that's how we ended up like securing the bird feeders. And then these other like double S hook thingies, sort of. It wasn't like an S hook, but it was kind of like, it had like 2 hooks on the end of it. I actually have no clue what it was, but like I said, we just used some stuff we found in the garage so we can actually hang the bird feeders up yesterday. So my dad ran back out to Menards today and to get the lattice, and then also to ended up picking up 4 of the hooks, which I wanted to go with all black. He said that they didn't have, because like the the decorative hooks that we have outside are sort of like a, I don't know, like warped, not warped metal, sort of like a, like rusty, not rusted, but like the color is sort of, it's like a black sort of, but it looks like sort of faded and like sort of, I don't know really how to describe it, but just like worn, I guess, kind of. And so the black ones I think matched really well, but my dad said they only had two left, so we got two of those and then two just regular white ones. So if they have some more of the black ones, we might start trying to replace them out. And because I think I told you guys, we have two holes drilled in each like cross beam, and we have six cross beams, so we can do 12 in total. So in the long run we might need 10 black ones, and we can use the white ones just somewhere else, you know, for something, but just for right now. So everything is sort of universal at the moment, so we might wind up changing those out. I don't totally know, but we just needed those actually for the actual bird feeders. So yeah, but I did see some birds outside today, guys. I saw actually a male and female cardinal in the front yard, and then just some sparrows, and I also saw a handful of sparrows in the backyard. And I felt really bad too, because every time I would walk past, I went and like would go and check outside to go and see if there are any birds out there, and there literally was none almost all day. And me and my dad went to go again fix the hooks, and I saw that there was some like bird seed on the ground and stuff like that that were cracked open, so I was assuming like probably a couple of birds were at least there this morning, right? So I ended up then, like I said, I was cooking dinner tonight, and actually I chopped up, I think I have all of the produce prepped for this week. And so I was doing that, and I was taking the excess, because I cut up like a watermelon and all that kind of stuff, so I was taking the watermelon rind out to the composter. And when I was doing that, all of a sudden there was a ton of sparrows in the backyard, and I was like, this is great, I have to go out to the composter, and I'm gonna scare them all away. So I went out there, and sure enough, they all flew away and got scared. And I was like, now they're probably like, oh, that's a scary spot, we don't want to come back there, there's a human that's coming outside. You know, as soon as they like get comfortable and they all start eating there, that's like immediately, because I went and checked, I actually had taken, that was the second like bucket of compost that I needed to take out there too. And so I ended up, like I said, I took the first one out, there was no birds, and then 5 or 10 minutes later I went back out, and sure enough there were birds. And just probably when they started getting comfortable, I went and scared them all. But yeah, so I'm hoping though that they again do sort of, you know, they're all sort of coming back, and they maybe figured out like, oh hey, they have food again, because again we stopped feeding them over that again the last few weeks. So while we were building the bird sanctuary in the backyard, and we were moving all the feeders around and all that kind of stuff. So now that that's all done, and we're feeding them again and everything, you know, we can, you know, they were hopefully will start coming back. And they're smart, smarter than I think we give most birds credit for, but they will find the food. So it just takes a little bit of time. Like I said, there were some sparrows in the front yard. There was the male and female cardinal were out there. But the thing that I'm just getting like really excited about though too is that because it is starting to kind of turn into fall and cooler weather and stuff like that soon as well, it will be more like that. But you know, because of that, we'll start getting some other, you know, birds that migrate, and some of the winter birds also and stuff like that. So I'm super excited about seeing all the different kinds of birds that we will start seeing soon. Will be awesome. So I also planted the morning glories, the last of the little, you know, packet that I had. I planted those in the other two buckets. So again, I told you guys, it was an old thing of flower seeds, and so I was just going to again plant them and see what happens. And the ones in the other two buckets that I started already, they've been coming up and are looking really good. And I did transplant a couple from one of the spots that we were growing them where we don't want them anymore. They're actually doing pretty well. I'm quite surprised, because I really thought they weren't going to do well at all, but they actually are looking like, you know, I was expecting them to have already shriveled up and died. They haven't yet, so we'll see how well they take to being transplanted. But you know, over the winter and everything like that, we'll see if they wind up coming back or not. And if not, we'll just get more seeds and plant more seeds out there, because again, it's like 50 cents or a dollar or whatever for, you know, the seed packets. So you know, we can have lots of morning glories and moonflowers. And my mom wants to do trumpet vine too, but most likely we'll have to find somebody that we can get trumpet vine for or from, because they don't have, that's not something that you can like get at the store. It's like an heirloom plant, like our rose bush in the front yard is an heirloom. We have resurrection lilies that are an heirloom, like those type of things you normally can't find at just like a generic hardware or greenhouse and stuff like that. You have to, my mom's friend actually got the rose bush that we have in the front yard. She got it from like an heirloom, like plant sale thing. So again, it's not something that most likely we will, I don't think we will find at just a normal greenhouse or just a grocery, not grocery store, but like a hardware store like Menards, or you know, even at the grocery store too, like Jewel has flowers and stuff like that, but it's not something that's super, super common. But I guess my mom was saying like it takes over, so a lot of times people are trying to dig it up and get rid of it because it just, it goes so fast. But since we're gonna have it contained into the buckets and the rest of it's gonna be grass that we can just mow, so even if it does wind up, any of this stuff winds up transplanting itself into the grass, we can just mow it over, you know, anything we don't want, and again just pull it up and stuff like that. So since it's in the grass too, it might not take very well to being in there. It might not be able to transplant itself very well either, so I don't have a big concern about that since we're doing it that way. But yeah guys, also too, I'm wearing today my Black Panther shirt because of the unfortunate news of Chadwick Boseman on Friday, and his passing was so sad guys, because like Black Panther is seriously probably one of my favorite, not only comic book, but like portrayed in the movies too, like superhero. And so it was so sad guys. And on top of that too, like all of his other movies that he's been in and stuff like that. So yeah, that was, it's just like, I honestly guys, I was like, I forgot too, like we lost Kobe at the beginning of this year. And then on top of that, like the pandemic, like 2020 has not, clearly has not been a friend at all. And it's so sad too, because I actually had really high hopes for 2020. Like I was like, yes, like it's a new decade, you know, kind of that whole thing. And literally so far, other than the first like 2 months, you know, we've been locked in our houses and we can't do anything. And again, so the loss of so many people and all this kind of stuff is just, it's like I said, 2020 is not my friend. I don't think a lot of people, so I'm not a fan. But anyways guys, I am gonna take a shower and get to bed. I will see you guys all in tomorrow's vlog. If you guys did enjoy today's, make sure you guys give the gold thumbs up. If you guys are new, we'd love it if you'd subscribe, and I'll see all of your sunshiny faces tomorrow. So bye guys.